I am Dr. Udayakumar from School of Humanities, National Institute of Advanced Studies, Bangalore. I am so glad to present my experimental research on iron technology in EXARC Experiment World Conference. Today I will be presenting my research paper on investigating the ancient heritage of Indian iron smelting technology through experimental approach. This research was part of my PhD thesis. Before starting my talk, I would like to thank Professor Shanti Pappu and Dr. Kumar Akhilesh and other staff from Sarma Center for Heritage Education, Chennai. In iron technology, there are two major processes involved, primary process and secondary process. In iron technology, there are different methods such as smelting, smithing, cold hammering and casting. The early iron age in India marks the period of beginning of iron technology, subsequently production and its whispered culture used along the subcontinent. Though initially research had described the date of about 7th to 6th century BC to emergence of iron in the Indian scenario, Wheeler 1946. Now the date for the same and it is harnessed to the culture development of the region goes back to the early period of 2nd millennium BC, Tiwari 2003. Experimental study of iron technology. As concerned to metal technology, in general, at archaeological sites, we find the base of furnace, broken parts of furnace, tuyeres in different size and shapes, slags, ash and charcoals. Metal technology is divided into two processes, primary process, smelting process, secondary process, forging and smithing. To understand any ancient technology, we need to keep doing experiment as much as times. Here I have conducted three phases of iron smelting process to understand the ancient iron smelting technology at Nathara-Ki-Pal. The site Nathara-Ki-Pal is located southeast 20 kilometers away from city Udaipur, Rajasthan. The site was excavated by Professor Vasant Shinde from Deccan College, Pune and Professor Lalit Pandey from Rajasthan University, Udaipur. The site was excavated from 2006 to 2008 and 2012 to 2013. The site belongs to early historical and medieval period. The site is highly potential of iron smelting process. We could collect base of furnace, tuyeres and numerous slags. My experiment study is focused on primary sources, smelting process. Smelting is the process of separating metal from ore by heating the ore until the metal with it turns the liquid. In general, at archaeological sites, we find base of the furnace, broken part of the furnace, tuyeres in different size and shapes, slags, ash, charcoals. The technical significance of these findings will be discussed here through experiment studies. Before starting the experiment of iron smelting, I have gone through the previous work which is very helpful to understand the basic concept of iron technology. Tripathi 2013, World on Agaria Tribes of Iron Workers of Central India and other scholars who had worked on metal technology. Aim and objective of the research: to obtain detailed knowledge of traditional techniques by reconstruction of the experimental iron smelting process, to study the skill of smith, to investigate the labor requirements, to analyze the time taken for smelting process, to study the scientific analysis of smelted iron slag from experimental work. Methodology of the research: information collection, literature sources and previous work, core collection and preparation, collection of clay, preparation of tuyeres, smelting process and scientific analysis of the research. Information collection of iron smelting process is based to understand the iron smelting technology. It includes a reference of previous experiment study in different regions of worldwide. This study helps to understand the outline and visual of experiment studies in iron smelting process. Ore collection and preparation. The iron ore was collected from the site of Nathara-Ki-Pal, located in Udaipur district, Rajasthan. It is an early historic and medieval culture site. The site was located in the foothill of iron ore mines and iron ore was available on the surface of the site. So it was easy to collect the iron ore. I have collected almost 80 kg of iron ore from the site for experimental study. The iron ore was transported from site to Sarma Center for Heritage Education, Chennai. The ores available in the site Nathara-Ki-Pal is hematite and magnetite. After collecting the iron ore from ancient mines, the iron ore has to be crushed into tiny pieces as much as possible before the smelting process. The process, because if we charge a lump of iron ore into the furnace, it will never get smelted. So the crushing the iron ore into the powder is very important stage in iron smelting process. Collecting clay plays very important role. In my experiment work, I have collected the clay from the lake near Sarma Center, Chennai. The clay was a black color, and later I have added red soil to strengthen the clay. The clay was kept into the water for 2 to 3 days to remove the impurities from the clay. Preparation of tuyeres. The term tuyeres basically means a noodle through which air blown at high draft into the furnace for smelting operation. The method of making tuyeres very simple. We have taken the wooden rod and cover it with the fine clay, and later cover it with a rough clay. Leave the clay to dry for 15 to 20 minutes. Then we have to remove the wooden rod in general manner. As a result, we will get a narrow shape of tuyeres. The tuyeres should be always narrow in shape, so it is easy to fit or join the tuyeres into the furnace and with other tuyeres. In my experiment work, I have made 6 tuyeres for the smelting process. Here I could understand the difference of tuyeres from experiment and tuyeres from archaeological site. The base of tuyeres from experiment and archaeological sample looks same. The base is in flat. The purpose of the flat base are the fit into the ground level for the furnace. First experiment work, the area of the furnace was marked out and then dig a small pit of the 9.5 cm depth and 7 cm diameter. The measurement was followed to build the experiment furnace from the measurement of the furnace of the site Nathara-Ki-Pal, which was given by excavator of the site. This is full built furnace with the help of measurement from archaeological sample. It was about 63 cm height. There is a 2 outlet for slag and for fitting the tuyeres. Here we could see the furnace of west and east facing direction. The furnace facing the north and south direction, and here we could see the method of fitting the tuyeres towards the furnace. Each tuyeres has to fit into proper alignment so the wind from the bellow passes properly into the furnace. Here we could see the thickness of the furnace. 16 cm thickness at the bottom of the furnace and 8 cm thickness at the top of the furnace or mouth of the furnace. The furnace wall always should be thick to keep the temperature in standard. Drawing of the furnace shows the proper measurement that we have followed. Smelting process. The aim of a smelting process to bring out the bloom iron to make a perfect object. Smelting process includes a number of operations such as time of firing, time of charging fuel and ores, method of discharging a bloom and slag. As concerned to the blower, during my first experiment, I have no proper leather bellow, but same I have made sure that I should not use any modern equipment to do experiment work. So myself and few staffs of Sarma Center, we decided to make a tube bellow which will help us to lift the temperature during this process. I have recorded the strokes of bellow by the person during a smelting process. Time interval of charcoal and iron ore charging into the furnace. We have charged the charcoal and iron ore in the layer method, so it is easy for iron ore to get smelt. Around 1:30 pm, we can see the red and little of blue flame on the top of the furnace. This indicates that iron ore has started to smelt. In between, at least every half an hour, we need to check the furnace and spread the charcoal and iron ore in the furnace into the proper way. This process is to there should not be any choke during the smelting process. Breaking of the furnace. I have started to break the furnace from the top to recover the lump of iron. While breaking of the furnace, I did not use any modern equipment. I have used only a sharp wooden rod to remove the furnace. Here I would see the comparative analysis of furnace wall from experiment work and archaeological sample. Through this analysis, I could see the inner and outer wall of the furnace. The comparative analysis will help to understand the archaeological assemblage and easy to understand the site of connected to technology. Through experiment of smelting process, we could recover a small piece of iron slag, and here we could see the same iron slag which was recovered from excavation. Base of the furnace. After removing the furnace wall, the base of the furnace shows the deposit of slag charcoal and few broken pieces of the furnace. Again, we have taken the case of archaeological sample of base from the site Nathara-Ki-Pal. The research shows that the base are similar. This analysis was helped to understand and locate the furnace during excavation or exploration. The second experiment work of iron smelting. Same pattern was followed from first round of experiment work, building of the furnace, smelting, etc. Here the base of the furnace was plastered with the red soil to compact the heat and reduce the choking during the smelting process. The measurement of building furnace was followed by archaeological measurement of the site in Nathara-Ki-Pal. Here the furnace has three outlets. One is for trapping the slag and another two is for fitting the leather bellows into the furnace. Picture shows the height and complete furnace. Here we could see outlet of the trapping slag from the furnace. Here we could see the top view of the furnace and thickness of furnace and the two outlet for fitting the bellow into the furnace. For the second round of experiment work, I have used a small hand leather bellow. In experiment work, I have taken notice on how gender plays a very important role. During experiment process, the time of charging charcoal and iron ore as recorded in systematic manner and the charging as done in layer method. Breaking of the furnace, same method which was used in the first experiment smelting process. We could recover almost 1/2 kg of rough iron in the second experiment work. In the third experiment of iron smelting process, I have followed all methods same as in the last two experiment work. But same time, there are some of new material as involved and upgrade of myself. Preheating. During the third experiment smelting process, I have done the preheating of the furnace. During last two experiment works, I did not do the preheating the furnace. So while smelting process, the furnace has absorbed most of the heat to dry the furnace. It was difficult to reach that high temperature, but if we preheat the furnace and make properly dry the furnace, then it is easy to raise the required temperature to smelt the iron ore. In the case of bellow, I could assess the proper leather bellow from my second experiment work. In India, the craft of making a leather bellow is in sunset condition. There are very few family who is doing this craft. I could find a leather bellow making in Solapur, Maharashtra. This person does different size of the bellows. Procedure for fixing bellow. Several experimental stages were followed to understand the iron techniques of ancient times. With repeat adjustment of the position and the angle of bellow, measuring distance from the furnace, arranging shape and length of tuyeres, adjusting to the stand and the nail on which the bellow were fixed. Its establishment of the framework on which the play with the rope to pull the bellow was fixed, weight and the length of the pole on which the rope to pull the bellow was attached were the steps taken for experimental work. Observation of iron smelting experiment study. The main aim is to understand and detect the experiment of iron smelting study is to understand the ancient technology. Through this experiment study, I could understand various aspects of iron smelting process. Overlapping of the furnace. During the experiment study, I could understand the overlapping furnace. In archaeological sites, Nathara-Ki-Pal, I could find the overlapping furnace, but the excavator has mentioned it was two different period, but as concerned to iron work, they rebuilt the new furnace on the top of the old furnace. We have ethnographic evidence shows that agrias from Madhya Pradesh, India, they practice this overlapping method. In experiment study also, I have built the new furnace near to the old furnace due to place requirement. So this overlapping furnace, most of the metal technology sites. Structure of tuyeres. Tuyeres plays a very important role in the metal technology which saves the leather bellow from the high temperature furnace and pass the wind in the proper frequency. If the tuyeres was not there, then it was very difficult to save the leather bellow because of the heat the bellow will turn. Charging of charcoal and ores. During a smelting process, charcoal and an iron ore should charge in layer wise. If we charge at one time charcoal and iron ore, then it will never get melted. Skill and labor requirements of smelting process. During the smelting process, skill and labor plays very important role. The smith should know the time interval of charging and condition of the furnace. Time period of the smelting process. Comparative archaeological aspects and experiment study. The comparative analysis is very important to understand the ancient technology. In my experiment, I have compared with archaeological data. The final understanding of the experiment work gives an understanding of the ancient technology. There was a lot of to discuss about the iron smelting process, but here I have given a short outline of my experiment work. Here I could like to take a thank Dr. Smriti Arichan and National Institute of Advanced Studies.